In this lesson, you will learn how to configure VLANs on Huawei switches. To do this, we will use this simple network topology, consists of two switches. Without VLAN configuration, let's check connectivity of the PCs. Here, we have four PCs, and each PC has its IP address as 10.10.10.x. Here, X is the PC number. Let's ping from PC1 to PC2, PC3, and PC4. All pings are successful. Without VLAN configuration, all PCs can access the others in this domain. Now, let's start VLAN configuration on switch 1. Firstly, we will create VLANs, VLAN 2, and VLAN 3. To create them, we will use VLAN VLAN ID command. To add also a description to the VLAN, we will use description command. Our VLANs are VLAN 2 and VLAN 3, and descriptions are sales and engineering. To check VLANs on the switch, we use display VLAN command. Our VLANs are here. Now, we will configure ports for VLANs as access port and trunk port. We will go to under Ethernet 0/0/1, and we will set this port as VLAN access port. To do this, we will use port link type access command. After that, we will assign VLAN to this access port. To assign VLAN 2, we will use port default VLAN 2 command. Again, for Ethernet 0/0/2, we will do the same configuration with different VLAN. Sorry, I made a wrong configuration here. This must be configured with VLAN 3. For the link between the switches, we should configure a trunk link. To do this, we will go to under interface gigabit Ethernet 0/0/1, and we will set it as trunk port. To do this, we will use port link type trunk command. After that, we will determine the allowed VLANs on this trunk. To allow only VLAN 2 and VLAN 3 on this trunk, we will use port trunk allow pass VLAN 2, 3 command. To save our configuration, we will use set save configuration or save command. After configuring VLANs on the first switch, it is time to do this on another switch. We will configure VLANs on switch 2-2. Then, we will configure ports for VLANs. Sorry, I made a wrong configuration here. This must be configured with VLAN 3. Again, let's go to under Ethernet 0/0/2 and configure it with VLAN 3. We will also configure Gigabit Ethernet 0/0/1 interface as trunk interface. Again, we will set allowed VLANs as VLAN 2 and VLAN 3. Lastly, we will save our configuration on switch 2. Let's check VLANs with display VLAN command. Our created VLANs are here. We have finished our VLAN configurations on Huawei switches. Now let's do a ping test to check the connectivity of the PCs. Here, we are expecting that only the PCs in the same VLAN can ping the other one. PC1 is in VLAN 2. Let's ping the other PC, PC3, which is also in VLAN 2. Yes, ping is successful. Now let's try to ping other PCs in another VLAN, VLAN 3. It is not successful as we expect. And also pinging to PC4 is not successful too, because both of these switches are in different VLANs. Let's also do a ping test on PC2. Ping from PC2 to PC1 is not successful as we have expected. Ping to PC3 is not successful too. But ping to PC4 will be successful, because PC2 and PC4 are in the same VLAN. Lastly, let's check some VLAN verification commands on Huawei switches. When we use display VLAN command, here are the options. Show VLAN summary command gives summary information about VLANs. To display information about specific VLAN, we can use display VLAN VLAN ID command. The one that we have used before, show VLAN command. Here, we can see our VLANs, access ports, but not trunk ports. Yes, we have finished our Huawei VLAN configuration example. We have configured two switches for VLAN 2 and VLAN 3. We have assigned ports to VLANs on each Huawei switch. We have configured trunk link between these switches. And lastly, we have verified our VLAN configuration with ping tests. If you like this video, do not forget to like and share with your friends. Good luck!